Well, John, first of all, very nice to see you back on our screens. And you were there an awful lot, of course, in the 1960s and 1970s. Can I ask you, first of all, how much you remember about the first championship you won in 68-69?
Well, that was a season where we lost two matches, John, all season out of 42. I think that record will stand for a long, long time yet. We lost them both in a week. We lost 3-1 at Manchester City one Saturday. The next Saturday we went to Burnley and lost 5-1. And it really was some record. And I feel that we got 67 points or 68 points, I'm not 100% sure. But only losing two games in a season was in the English First Division at that time, when there's a lot of good teams about, was really special.
Now, when you look back on your Leeds side, there was obviously so much quality about it, and it's, I suppose, difficult to individualise, but were there players, or was there a player, that you thought was more the key to it than anybody else?
No, I don't think so, John. I think that in their own rights, every one of them were great players. They could all do things in certain situations that were required of them. And that was the beauty of them, that we had, 16 internationals out of an 18 first-team pool. And all the lads who didn't get in the team were so valuable to us, it wasn't true. The Terry Orlison, David Howie for a long time, and Mick Bates. And I do feel there were so many talented players, world-class players, in that team that could do anything. There's so much talent, and they only got appreciated the last 4 years. From 70 to 74, they really turned into some football that made the country sit up and take notice.
Some of those matches at Elland Road, I'm thinking of the game, for example, when you demolished Southampton with 7 goals and you beat Manchester United with 5 around the same time. Some of the football at Elland Road was of a very high order. How do you think that Leeds team compared in footballing terms with other championship sides that you obviously watched and played against and managed against in the post-war period?
I would think the Tottenham side, the Pushingman side that Bill Nick had with John White and Danny Blanchflower and Dave Mackay and all that was an excellent side. I thought the Arsenal side that did the double were very, very professional and a good side. The Manchester United side of 67, the one that pipped us that year for the championship. I would think that these three, Everton had a good side when they had Ball, Harvey, Kendall and Higton and all that crowd. I would think that the Leeds United side of that time, especially the 74 season when they were all matured and good players, great world-class players, I would think they would compare with any of these teams, along with Liverpool, of course. Liverpool had some great teams in the championship years under Shanks, and then Bob Paisley did a remarkable job carrying it on, and Joe Fagan.
What about your own personal relationship with the players? How essential was that to the way that the club was built at that time?
Well, I think there was a great respect from me to them and from them back to me. We were very, very close, John, as you know, because you were there the early days when you were just starting. And I don't know, there was a bond that nobody could break. Everybody said, oh, the professional and the ruthless and this and this. But we used to love being our own little close-knit family, and the more people knocked us, the more we'd get our heads down and have a go. The relationship was very much part of the championship.
You mentioned the word ruthless there, and you had to obviously live with a certain amount of criticism. And I saw Johnny Giles wrote an article recently saying, well, looking back on it, we were a bit cynical and we bent the rules as far as you could and that type of thing. Now, when you look back, do you have any regrets about the stance that you took and the attitude which Leeds took onto the field?
No, Jack Charlton always said I used a word that was totally misconstrued. I used the word professionalism. Now, by being professional, I meant that players had to learn something every day in training or improve the skill. Or know that every player they played against in every First Division team, which way they would turn, which way they used to like to go when they were going to try and beat you, were they good in the air, which foot did they kick with, did the ball watch, all this type of thing. And I expected them to keep learning and going to bed early and eating the right foods, if they were going to be the great side, and possibly we tried to win the European Cup, then go on and win the World Championship. But that word was used by the press and people in the media. Professionalism was possibly the wrong word. If I'd said thinking about the game and flair and all that stuff, possibly wouldn't have got the stick that we did get. But we were, if a team, like some teams would come to Elland Road and they would try and come out. The manager must have steamed them up and said, well, if you don't go out and match this team for effort and tackling and fight, they'll run all over the top of you. And some of the managers were asking their team to do something they weren't capable of doing. You know, good footballing side would come to Elland Road and try and mix it right from the first whistle. And I used to say to our players, whatever you do, don't get involved because it's not worth it. Then after 15, 20 minutes, when they were getting kicked about a bit, little Billy or Johnny Jallow would look at the box and I'd say, all right, sort it out for 20 minutes. So you could have it either way with them. That was the great thing about that team. If you wanted hard match, you could have hard match. If you wanted pure football and skills, you could have that too.